Hey folks, one possible issue people have with writing web applications in Python is they still have to learn at least some JavaScript or a JavaScript-centric framework to do something useful. But here and there, we're seeing solutions emerge that let you write full websites, including rich front-end interactivity, with nothing but a Python backend. Today, I'm going to look at one of these projects called Reflex. Reflex was originally called Pinecone, with a Y, when it was first rolled out to the public in December of 2022. As of July 2023, it's available as a public beta. It's still not recommended for enterprise production work, but it is useful enough to try out and build atop of provisionally. The basic idea with Reflex is that you create web apps using components, basically Python objects. And these objects describe the structure of the page, the look of the elements, and their behaviors, such as what happens when you click a button. Reflex comes with a whole gallery of built-in object types, and the best part is how they reflect many common use cases. For instance, everyone I know of struggles to take an element and center it on a web page. With Reflex, you use the reflex.center element, you set the height to 100%, and you go about your business. It is literally that simple. Let me zoom in on a few examples a little more closely. In this demo, we're creating a form with a counter and three buttons, increment, decrement, and randomize. This block of nested objects here describes the layout of the page, and the dot button elements each have onClick functions assigned to them. The state for the page is held in a state object, which is a subclass of a type Reflex provides for managing state on a web page. And you can also see how inline CSS declarations can be supported easily. Now, if you want to include scripts or HTML manually, you can do that by other components too. For instance, if I wanted to add an existing third-party JavaScript component, like a rich text editor, I could put that in by hand. Another convenient thing Reflex gives us is live reloading. If I make a change to my application, you can see here that the app is restarted automatically, and the changes are reflected almost instantly. This shortens the development cycle a good deal, especially for things like constantly tweaking a UI. If you want to add your own custom components, Reflex provides a way to write them yourself, or you can take existing components written in React and deploy those. That does mean you may have to do some heavy lifting with React to achieve more advanced effects, but the broad range of existing React components out there means there's a good chance what you need already exists. The best way to get started with Reflex, in my opinion, is to take a look at the gallery of examples on the Reflex site, pull a couple of them that reflect use cases you have, and see how they work. For instance, if you wanted to create a database-backed app and you want to see how Reflex's built-in ORM supports a given use case, you can filter by database and choose something suitable. Now, with any kind of web application, at some point you're going to need to grapple directly with the nitty-gritty. You can't entirely put off first-hand experience with HTML and CSS and JavaScript and their associated technologies. But projects like Reflex are meant to minimize the amount of tedium and context switching associated with building such things. They aren't meant to completely replace learning about HTML or JavaScript, but they're meant to make it easier for Python users to build things that use those technologies. So again, while Reflex is still an alpha product, it's worth experimenting with right now to see if it can make your Python-powered web projects easier to build and deploy. So that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below, and don't forget to follow Dev with Sirdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.